Hello students, today we will study about the occurrence of metals in nature. Okay, see, in nature metals they are occurred as free, in free state or in combined state. So if free state we are talking about the metals occurring in the free metallic form not acted upon by natural elements like constituent of air and water, they do not react with them at all. Like gold and platinum, if we talk about, they cannot react with any other metal, and these are called noble metals. So these are the noble metals which do not react with any of the compounds, like any of the elements. They do not combine. Like gold, if we keep it for very long, then too it will not react with oxygen to form any layer of oxide on it. So these metals, these are obtained in their native or free state. Combined state, if you talk about, there are many metals which are found in their compound state, and this is called combined state. Like if we talk about bauxite, the formula for bauxite is Al2O3.2H2O. Okay, this is an ore of aluminium. So aluminium we can obtain from this bauxite. Zincite, ZnO, it is also found in C, combined state, zinc. Hematite, oxide of iron, Fe2O3. Okay, cuprite, Cu2O. So these metals here, they are combined in, they are present in combined state. Now carbonate, see carbonate, siderite, FeCO3, marble, the formula for marble, it is CaCO3, calamine is ZnCO3, and magnesite, it is MgCO3. These all are the carbonates of these metals. Now here, halides, if we talk about, it's cryolite. See what we have to study in this chapter, it is cryolite. Okay, bauxite also you have to study so much about this also, and this also. Now fluorspar also, cryolite, the formula for cryolite, it is Na3AlF6, cryolite. See aluminium, fluorspar, CaF2. Horn silver, it's AgCl. Rock salt, NaCl. Sulfides, if we talk about, iron pyrite, FeS2. Zinc blend, ZnS is zinc blend. Galena, PbS. Cinnabar, HgS. This also you will study. Gypsum, this is CaSO4.2H2O. Calcium sulfate dihydrate. Anglesite, PbSO4. Barite, BaSO4, and Epsom salt is MgSO4.7H2O, magnesium sulfate heptahydrate. Okay, so these are the metals or elements which are present in their combined state. Now these are the definitions which we must know before starting the chapter. Minerals are the compounds of various metals. They are found in nature. They are associated with their earthly impurities, and these are called minerals. Minerals are those compounds in which metal is present, and we extract them from earth surface or earth. Now ore. See, ore, if we talk about, ore is also a mineral. It is also the naturally occurring mineral from which metals can be extracted profitably and conveniently. Many minerals can be there, but out of all those minerals, ore will be that mineral from which we can extract the metal very easily and profitably. Okay, and that ore will be, that mineral will be called an ore. So if we talk about ore can be a mineral, but all minerals cannot be ores. Now other terms used in metallurgy, the first one is metallurgy only. It is a large scale processes. It involves the extraction of pure metal from their respective ores. See, ores we are having, we'll clean those oars, we'll do the dressing of those oars, then we'll concentrate those oars, and then the process of converting that those oars into their oxides, and then the reduction process. After that also we'll do electrometallurgy or electro refining also. So this is a very long process which we will study here. Next is matrix. The rocky impurities including silica, mud, etc., which are associated with the ore. All these impurities are called matrix or gang. Now flux. The substance added to the ore. It is the substance which is added to the ore to get rid of the matrix. Suppose matrix, it is mixed with the ore and we want to remove that matrix. So we can add flux to it. When we will add flux, matrix, it results in the formation of a fusible compound called slag. This flux will combine with matrix, leaving behind the ore. This flux will combine with matrix and upon combination it will form slag. This slag can come out and what is left there will be the pure ore. Okay, so the substance added to the ore to get rid of the matrix, to get rid this matrix, this gang. And it results in the formation of a fusible compound called slag. Now see, common ore of aluminium, zinc and iron. These are the common ores like bauxite, cryolite, corundum. Bauxite is Al2O3.2H2O. Cryolite is Na3AlF6. And corundum is Al2O3. Now ores of zinc. Zinc blend, calamine and zincite. Zinc blend is ZnS. Calamine is ZnCO3 and zincite is ZnO. Hematite, magnetite, iron pyrites and sphatic iron ore. Hematite Fe2O3, magnetite Fe3O4, iron pyrites it's FeS2, sphatic iron ore it's FeCO3. So this was all about the process of metallurgy, where we have studied that elements, they are found in, or the metals, they are found in their native and combined state. Minerals are the compounds from which we extract ore, and minerals, they are associated with their earthly impurities. Ores are those minerals from which we can obtain or extract the ore, the metal profitably and conveniently. That mineral will be called an ore. Metallurgy, it is the process of extraction of pure metal from its ore. Matrix is the impurity which is associated with the ore. Flux is the substance which is added to get rid this matrix from ore. And they combine to form a fusible compound called slag. And these are some common ores of aluminium, zinc and iron. Tomorrow we will start with the extraction process, where we'll discuss the dressing of the ore, conversion of ore to its oxides, reduction process and electro refining. This all we'll study in short, and then we'll do the description of that.